Oh, hi there. My name's Alex. I had sent an inquiry a little while ago about seeing Dr. Merton. I saw him a few years ago regarding a surgery. I had a consultation, but I didn't actually go ahead with the operation at the time. But I wanted to go ahead now, but I was wondering if that initial consultation I'd done a few years ago, if I need to do a new one.
He definitely needs to see you again pre-surgery, so there would be an additional fee or an appointment fee. You'd likely need an updated quote as well if it was a few years ago, but I can look up your file if you like. If you want to move forward for the appointment, is it something that you're hoping to have the appointment before Christmas or next year?
Just whenever, whenever the next available one was. It's not...
Okay, I do have Monday the 20th. It's coming up close to Christmas, but that's the only thing I have, and then it would be February of next year.
Okay, that would be fine, Monday the 20th.
Thank you so much for coming with me today.
No, of course.
Moral support.
Of course.
I can't believe today's the day. Wow, look at that. Oh, wow, that's so pretty. Wow, it's so beautiful. I want to do that at my house.
Forget about the boobs, I just want flowers.
This is what it looks like to be shitting bricks.
The first thing he said to me, he opened the door and he went, "Didn't you used to be a redhead?" That's the very first thing he said. I was like, "Wow, you remember?" And he's like, "Of course I remember." Because I've seen him a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Anyway, so he gave me a prod, told me I have the smallest boobs that he's seen.
Okay.
He was like, I was showing him, I said, "Oh, I've saved some pictures of other ladies on your website that, like, they have similar breasts to me." And he was like, "To be fair, no one's got similar breasts to you. You don't really have anything." He was like, "You've got there's no breast tissue." He was like, "It's skin and nipples. That's all you have." So he said apparently when I like lost weight, I lost everything
all
that was
tissue.
Here. And he was like, "Well, it's most likely that what was there was like fat. It wasn't breast tissue. When I was bigger, it was I was carrying fat," kind of thing.
Right.
But anyway, he was like, "Yeah, you don't have anything at all." So he was like, "I've got to give you under the muscle," because he said, "I wouldn't dare give you over because you've got nothing there to hold it." And he was like, "It'll just slide all around the place and you'll see like a big line, you'll see it like a crevice kind of thing where they're sitting." So he said, "It's got to be under the muscle." Mm-hmm. And then he said, he doesn't recommend that I get round ones. He wants me to get the teardrop. Because he said, because I was saying like, my issue is that I've got nothing up here. So it's like flat here and then it kind of kicks out a little bit here. And he said, if he gave me the round ones, the nipple wouldn't change its location. Mm. So he was like, imagine like a round circle and you want your nipple to be like here.
Yeah.
But if he put round on me, the nipple would kind of sit
here,
it would point downwards.
Yep, yep, yep.
But he said with the teardrop, because it's got this scoop shape, it will scoop under the nipple and project the nipple like up higher.
Mm.
And I told him like, I want more fullness up in this section. I don't really care about projection, like how far out it comes. I just want more sort of fullness. And he said, the gap between my boobs is actually very wide. Mm. So he was showing me images of some other ladies where when you put the implants in, the implants themselves just create a cleavage, even like when they're not even wearing a bra, like there's just, they're so close together because of how wide their sternum is.
Mm.
But mine is so wide, and he said you can't put the implants over the bone, but this is such a wide bone here that the implant will stop there and it'll stop there. So he's like, you'll only get cleavage when you have a push-up bra to push them together, which is fine.
A lot of women have that.
That's what I expected, to be fair. He told me, he was like, "What cup size do you want?" And I was like, "I think I want B, because I don't want bigger, I just want round fullness."
Yeah.
And he was like, "B isn't going to work, because in order to get the fullness up the top, because it's a circle," he was like, "we can't kind of just give you something small, because then it'll be small, so there won't be any fullness."
Right.
So he's like, "You've got to go to a C," but they just do different depths. So it's like just, projection. So he was like, "We won't do one that sticks out really far. It'll be a C, but it'll just be more flat against the chest." So his recommendation was 315 cc.
Okay.
Teardrop. And then he was explaining to me like there's a difference between, you can get smooth implants and textured implants.
Mm.
And there's a payoff for both. So he said that the smooth implants have less of a risk of this particular type of breast cancer that you can get. but they have a higher likelihood to move. And he said sometimes they put them in and they start here, and in 6 months they end up down here because they just slip
because they have no grip.
Yeah, and then they've got to reoperate and put it back. And he's like, it can happen multiple times. So the risk of having to continuously reoperate to keep putting them back in position, that the complications associated with multiple operations, he thinks outweighs the risk of if you have the textured implants, which are more grippy, so they stay in their spot. But apparently, like, 1 in 64,000 women are at risk of developing this type of breast cancer associated with that textured implant. It's something to do with, like, the textured implant and how it affects
your body.
But he said he essentially stopped using the smooth implants. He said that he has them available if someone wants it, but he doesn't recommend them because he said the risk of the smooth ones slipping out of place and having to reoperate again and put you on that anesthetic again and go the risk of like infection and all that sort of thing over and over again. He's like, it's safer to go with the other one. And then he said you should have them taken out or replaced after 15 to 20 years.
Okay.
So, but I'm almost 30. So he's like, you'll be in your 50s and like you'll have had kids and all that sort of thing. And like, if you wanted, he's like, you don't need a breast lift. But if you, after you've had kids and all that, if you want a breast lift, you like wait 15 years, 20 years. And then you're 50s, you can get a lift and you can have them replaced if you want to. And then other than that, it's, do you know how much these sort of things cost?
I want to say it's between 10 to 20 grand.
So all up, for his fees, it's 8,000. Okay. And then for the hospital and then the anaesthetist, it's going to come to 11,000 all up. Which is what I was expecting.
Yeah, yeah.
The funny thing is, when I saw him years ago, I think the total was going to be 8, and I didn't go ahead with it back then. So in waiting a couple of years, I have not saved myself.
Well,
it's gone up in price, but
yeah.
I'm also more comfortable doing it now.
More certain, and that's worth more than anything.
Yeah, and I booked in.
Oh!
1st of February.
Wait, that's in like 2 months! Oh my god!
Yeah, I'm going back to my pre-op appointment on the 19th of January, and then
that's in like 3 weeks.
I know.
Oh my god.
He was like, I don't have any availability for like well into halfway through next year, but he was like, but you're very small and we're not doing very much to you, so. And he was looking through his calendar and he's like, this day here is fully booked, but I think I can put you in right here. I'll come in early and I can put you in here. And it's really funny. He wrote, oh, I've got it in my handbag. He wrote a little post-it note and it says, 1st Feb, okay. And then he says, give this to the ladies at the front desk, they'll know what it means. And I was like, ah, thank you, I will frame it and I'll put it with, you know, with my before and after photo. And then he was like, well, give it to the ladies, and like, because otherwise they won't give you the date if you don't give them this note. So I go to the desk and I was like, I have this special note for you. And they looked at it and they burst out laughing and they were like, we should frame this. I was like, that's what I said. They were like, do you want to take it? And I was like, yeah, I'll take it. So I just got this little note in my bag. It's like, 1st of Feb.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, that's so exciting.
So I paid a $500 deposit. And I haven't told Dan yet.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, he's given me these 3D rendered images. I'll show you.
Oh, nice.
Of what it'll look like. Ooh, and he was like, you can show your husband and like... But I didn't tell him. I was like, Dan doesn't know. But I feel like if I go to Dan, I'm like, hun, I've got something cool to show you. You know what's going to happen on the 1st of February? This! And if I just show
like 3D, him, like CGI boob.
And instead of being like, no, you shouldn't get a boob job, he'll be like, well, okay then. How much is this going to cost? Don't. Honey will handle it. HelloFresh has got me.
Can I show you something? So I wasn't entirely honest with you about why I went to the city today. I went for a consultation.
Oh, for boobs.
And this is actually me.
Wow.
That's my actual body that he photographed. And that's what it would look like. With 315cc, teardrop shape, under the muscle.
Yeah. What do you think?
I didn't think it would look that nice. So I was really happy when I saw that. Anyway, so he like fully understood. I explained to him
verbally what I wanted without even having showing him any pictures, because I'd saved a bunch of pictures of what I wanted. And without me even showing him the pictures, he was like, I think what you want is going to be something like this. Is this what you're telling me? And like, this is, he did this projection. And I was like, that's better than what I wanted, because like, it's not huge, you know, like they're not crazy boobs, but they're like nice. Like they look really nice. And like, that's a feminine looking body to me. So I think I would feel a lot better about myself if I kind of, you know that I don't really like to look at myself. So. I booked it, so.
Those ones. Can you show me your reference photos? I'm curious.
Can you pass me my phone?
Where are these tits you found on the internet that you're like, I like these tits?
They're his tits. They're tits that he's done. You know what the first thing he said to me was? When I walked in? Didn't you used to have red hair? He recognized me. I was like, how do you remember? And he was like, I'll always remember you.
Yeah, wow.
But he said, apparently I have the smallest boobs he's ever worked on. He was like, not to be offensive, but he was like, you don't actually have any breast tissue. Like when you lost weight, you mustn't have had it. You must've had fat in your boobs. If you had boobs, it must've just been fat. Cause he was like, you don't have any tissue here. He's like, it's just skin and nipple. There's nothing else. He was like, he said the before and after images on my website that you're looking at, I won't be able to give you exactly what those girls have to the same size that I gave those girls, because they had more breast than you have. So for me to give you the final outcome that they have, I've got to give you a bigger implant. Because I showed him this and I said, like, I really like her boobs, how they turned out. And that was 275cc. And he was like, if I gave you 275cc, you would still have tiny boobs. And like this one, I said I really liked the look of this, like that shape. And that was round implants, 310cc. And I said, I want this, you know, round. And he was like, no, you shouldn't have round because you're so thin and you don't have as much breast tissue as she has. So you need to go bigger than 315. But teardrop, he said, see how her natural nipples are like up,
centered, yeah.
Whereas mine are like down.
Yeah.
Mine sag downwards, but hers are higher.
Correct.
So he was like, she could have round, and then round just sort of pushed them out from where they were.
Yeah, but yours, you need shape to bring them in.
Yeah, so essentially like the shape of the implant won't, it'll just, wherever your nipples sit, round ones will just push it further from that point, but teardrop will actually lift. So anyway, so he didn't have any availability until very late into next year, but you're a very small person and it's a very small procedure that I'm doing to you, because he's only going to make one. He's like, I'm not giving you a lift. Like a breast lift would be if you know they actually like lift all of this up. He's like, we're not going to give you a lift or anything, so it's not going to take too long, like an hour and a half, 2 hours maybe.
Wow.
So he said he can fit me in on the 1st of February.
Wow, that's so soon.
Is that okay?
That's fine. Oh, you're gonna be out again for Nat's birthday.
He said it's a day procedure. You just go home and then you have like a binding bra.
Oh yeah, I remember when Tash had it, yeah.
And then you have like a training bra for the week after that. But he was like, just don't do any big exercise for a month, but you can do your normal life. He's like, you'll be sore, but you'll be... He was like, it's nothing compared to a nose job. It was so funny because when he was writing down like, okay, medical history, I said, oh, I've had a rhinoplasty. And he was like, I said, I've had two rhinoplasties. He's like, well, I'm glad you didn't come to me for that. And I was like, well, maybe I should have, because it was botched both times. And he was like, this is the exact reason I don't give nose jobs anymore. Because when I last saw him, he was doing nose jobs.
Mm.
He was like, I stopped. Like, he said, it's such a difficult procedure and so much can go wrong.
Yeah.
But he's like, I just pulled rhinoplasty off my books. Like, I don't do it anymore. And he was like, who are you going to see for your revision? And I said, well, if I'm going... I wanted to see Dr. Shahidi in the first place and I didn't go with him. He said, who'd you go with? And I said, Dr. He was like, oh. He was like, I won't say it. And I was like, what? He was like, no. Yeah, anyway, so I put down a $500 like deposit because I said...
Is it what, 16,000?
16, 18?
Yeah.
Do you think that's how much it'll be? It is... 11. So his fees are 8. And then for the hospital,
and for the anaesthetist, it comes up to 11.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I booked in the date tentatively, and he was like, I'll give you these images and you can go home and show your husband. And like, you know, obviously if I'm not going to go ahead with it, I just pull out. But I did a consultation years ago with him about the boobs. And we went through all of this, but this is before he didn't have this imagery and all this sort of thing back then. And obviously back then was before YouTube and everything, and I didn't have the money. And I was just like, okay, I'll save up, kind of. And then I never went back, never did it. But he said to me, he was like, when are you planning on having kids? And I said, I feel like we might have a good 5 years maybe in us before we want to do that, unless anything unplanned happens. But like 5 years probably at least. And he was like, okay, well, you can breastfeed with these. Like I would recommend after 15 to 20 years have them taken out or replaced, because the silicone can degrade after that point.
Yeah.
But he was like, then if you wanted to have them replaced in 15 years or 20 years, you can come have new ones put in, and then we can also give you a lift. Like a lot of women when they're in their like late 40s to 50s, he was like, so we can do that at the same time. We can give you a lift.
Take them out. Reduce the implants off.
Yeah. So,
stop.